Alright guys, so I'm going to be getting into a bit more vlogging, and I've just boosted down to the northern beaches. It's about 2 foot of swell, but I'm in a southerly protected area and it's southerly swell. So I'm going to give it a crack. A bit of wind's just picked up, I don't know if you can see, but it doesn't look too bad. So the target for today is going to be kingfish. Now it is the middle of winter, and I've been seeing so many kingfish, it's actually ridiculous. I'm going to roll on a couple of those clips, but yeah, just numbers of them, like all around the 70 to 80 mark, and probably schools of about 40 to 50. A couple of times I've been vortexed, which has been really good, and yeah, just got some mean footage that I want to send across and show you guys. But there's no reason why you can't shoot kingfish in Sydney. The water temperature's been surprisingly warm. We've been seeing around 18 to 19 degrees June, July, so can't really complain with that temperature, and it doesn't surprise me that you do see these fish coming in and they're in really close, so hopefully, yeah, plug a big one. There's two things that I've discovered since having kids. Baby powder, is that baby wipes. Neat little trick that I learned being a daddy, being a papa. Powder straight in. All right, so I got standard socks, BCF booties, gloves from Bunnings, dye bars, my Rife Euro 120 with a reel, 7mm shaft. This is what you need. All right, that's some of this. Need a bigger belt. Hey mate. Yeah.
Jumping in, we head straight to the Yakka. I mentioned the water had been a nice 18 degrees, but today was 16.5.
So yeah, we basically do a couple of drops in this spot and decide we want to move further along, and no sooner do we do that and we do our first drop and these nice school of probably 70 to 80 centimeter models come along. Schools of salmon were flying past us sporadically, and it's worth dropping down when they do, because you never know when some kings are going to be tagging along with them. And luckily that's what happened on this drop. I was able to plug a 73 model.
This has been a typical winter's dive. Every time that I've been targeting kingfish, I've seen schools around the 70 to 90 centimeter mark, lurking around, and you do get the odd hoodlum coming around as well. And the next few clips will just show you the last 2 months of diving. I want to feel what you want.
Fat little kingy, I've got two of them. I've got one in the fridge, but I'm starving as, so I just want to get some fillets going. So I'm gonna cut this up real quick. Does the job, you just basically follow it on with the tip of your knife, follow it along, and just lock in over those nodules there. So, got one, two, three, four, and it's just making its way. That's one fillet there. Alright, next is the wings, which are the best part. So I just kind of cut in there, work through that spinal bone, and same thing here, cut in here, and there you've got the wings. Real basic Mediterranean style, and I'll just grill that for about 20, 30, not even 20 minutes on medium heat. And that'll be a real tasty treat right there. All right, this is literally going to be sashimi, and I am going pretty rough with it. I'm just cutting them straight up because I am starving. 1/4 mirin, soy sauce on the back, wasabi. Coat it, get those juices, acids cooking it a little bit. Real high fat content, this one. What a ridiculous day. Have a go at that. Mate, shut the gates. If you can get yourself some of this, it's the mutt's nuts. 1/3 powder, 2/3 water. You just give that a bit of a whisk. You just want it so there's a nice consistency, like a thick paste. Just throw a little bit more in there. I don't know where you get this from, just your Asian supermarket is where I'd imagine you get it from. There we go. So as you can see, that's starting to thicken up right now. It's come out pretty good. It's got the nice batter on there. Doing the old Brody Moss Young Bloods wrap. And Brody Moss, we know what your secret sauce is. So this is sriracha mayo. So it's really nice. So this one has got a nice little chili flavour too.
Alright, so that's our fish wrap for the night. I think that fish was swimming around, I don't know, 3 hours ago. What we're going to do with this next is we're going to smoke that up. So I'm going to do a dry brine for 4 hours. 1/4 salt, 3/4 brown sugar. A dry brine will get all the moisture out of a kingfish within 4 hours. So you can put it in for 4 hours in the fridge brining and you can smoke straight away. So we've got our smoke kingy in our Arosto smoker. It's been on the dry brine for about 4 hours and then just dripping overnight, just that excess moisture. You really want that to sort of drip out. So I'm probably gonna smoke it for about an hour and 15 minutes at around 200. The key is to not let it dry out, water in the smoker. So it'll hopefully give it that moisture, and I'll check it about 40 minutes in.
And if it's dried out, I'll just give it a bit of a marinade on top, like marmalade marinade, and that should just retain the moisture in it, and hopefully she comes out all right. 40 minutes or nearly an hour, and we're just sitting at just around 220. And so you just keep the moisture on there. Don't let them dry out. All right, just turn it off. Woo-hoo-hoo. Get out that beautiful smoky flavor. Oh, that looks good. Hope you enjoyed this catch and cook. Please subscribe, hit that bell, and stay posted. I've got a lobster catch and cook coming up next. A couple of the boys and myself, we go for a night dive just on the northern beaches.